Welcome to the show. My first guest brings a spot of culture to tonight's show, since she is Britain's foremost poetess, the woman who's done more popularized verse than a dozen Eskimo Nels. Ladies and gentlemen, Pam Ayres. Very nice to have you on the show, Pam.
Thank you, Faith, for welcoming me to your fine and wondrous show. I'm ever so glad you invited me here, because I had nowhere else to go.
Now, everyone knows your ability to write poetry, Pam, but are you a creative person in other directions?
Oh, yes. Once I did dream a brilliant skein, so I thought I might as well risk it. I crossed a yo-yo with a custard cream and invented a self-dunkin' biscuit.
And would you confess that it was a success?
It failed. You see, I've never been a fortunate sort. In fact, my bad luck is renowned. Saccharine tablets make me put on weight. And I once bought a duck, but it drowned.
But you can't be unlucky in everything. How do you get on in your love life?
Disastrous. It's downright impossible to find a bloke when you're plain and frumpy and coy. If I were to jump over the side of a ship, no one would throw me a boy.
If you could get one, what kind of a man would you like?
Well, I've never set my sights so high. I'm a realist through and through. My idea of men would be a 40-year-old, but 2 20-year-olds will do.
Anyway, Pam, now that you're here, do you think it would be possible for you to sort of make up a poem on the spot?
No. I'd like to compose you a romantic poem about a dairy maid's love for a navvy, but I can't, because the only time I get flushed with ideas is when I'm sitting at home on the lavvy. I think we better go now. I have not got bored.
Oh, well, you can't win them all. Let's meet my next guest. It's my pleasure to welcome our First Lady of Politics, the woman who's been described as Britain's equivalent of Joan of Arc, because quite a few people would like to set fire to her. The Right Honourable Margaret Thatcher. Good evening, Prime Minister.
Good evening, Miss Brown. And good evening to you, big box watchers.
Now, I believe you have a surprise in store for us tonight. You're going to reveal to us your plans for a fourth television channel.
Indeed I am, Miss Brown. As you know, everybody is getting sick and tired of the same old party political broadcasts. So what we conservatives are going to do on the fourth channel is to put across our message in a far more entertaining way.
Not only. And how do you propose to do that?
Oh, successfully, of course. Now, I've brought along